And I'm Evan Heisler.
And welcome to the How. So Evan, have you cooked anything good lately?
I tend to burn everything even when I'm trying to boil water.
Well, maybe this next segment featuring Haley will help you learn some useful tips about cooking.
We're boiling over to Miss Bauer's room to sample some of Haley's award-winning cake. Good morning, BTMS. We're here with Haley, who's cooking up a storm. Haley, tell us about yourself.
Well, I recently won CHOP Junior, and I also went in again to be on the championships tournament. And also, I got a scholarship to the Culinary Institute of America that will hopefully keep growing. All right, and now I'm just going to show you guys how to make my winning cake. So to start, you're gonna take some butter and just put about the whole stick in. With that, you're also gonna put in some chocolate chips. And now we can start on our wet mixture. And this includes eggs and sugar, mostly. And then we're gonna add in some vanilla for a little tang. Next, I'm just going to start cracking my eggs. I'm then going to whisk these together until they are combined. Next, I'm just going to add in my chocolate chips, little at a time. So next, I just added in my next batch of chocolate chips, and this is going to be the final batch. And all we want is a really liquidy but kind of thick chocolate sauce. So just in between is perfect. Next, we are going to fold in the cool chocolate into our egg. Right now, I'm making the cream cheese swirl that's gonna go in my cake. And the cool thing about this cake is that I've never made it the same. I always do a different take on it. And right here, I just added in some sugar, and now I'm gonna add in just a little bit of vanilla. And I did about a fourth cup of sugar and about 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And this is just gonna make the perfect swirl. Next, to make it look like the cheesecake, I'm just gonna add 1 egg to this. And with this mixture, you wanna make sure you do not, if you are gonna make this at home, you wanna make sure that you do not overmix it. You wanna get all the egg to be perfectly swirled in, but you don't wanna overmix it or else it won't rise up. So right now, I'm just going to start assembling my cake, and I'm just gonna do about a fourth a cup, and then keep going until I'm about 3/4 of the way up. And the next thing I'm gonna do after I fill this all the way up is going to be swirling in. So right now, I'm just gonna swirl in my cream cheese mixture. And I'm just gonna swirl this around until I get a nice looking mixture that comes together real good. And with these cakes, I just had to butter the pan, and now I'm just gonna clean off any of the excess batter that got on here. So, did you guys figure out what the secret ingredient is?
Bacon?
Yep.
You can't get this trivia answer correct.
Do you want to put money on that?
Do you ever like to just stop and look around? So Evan, did you get the trivia answer right?
Yeah.
Around?
Yeah, sometimes it's nice to slow down and capture the moment. Thank you.
So Evan, did you know I saw the movie It yesterday? I'm really nervous about getting jump scares.
You might want to close your eyes for the next segment.
Boo!
Ah!
These are detectives Haley and Jacob. There's a monster on the loose, and it's up to them to catch it.
If you don't capture the moments will capture you.
So, Hunter, you mentioned you saw It yesterday. Where'd you have to go to see that?
Well, I had to drive all the way to Charlotte through the traffic.
Well, new plans could put a movie theater right here in Fort Mill on Main Street.
Fort Mill has changed over the years. Let's start with the theater on Main Street. It was built in 1947 and was a theater until it closed in the 70s. In 1990, a fire damaged part of the building. They are now renovating this theater. Not many people know about this theater, so let's see who does.
Would you go to the Main Street Theater?
Not really.
Yeah, not really.
Like, it depends.
Like, usually
the
when,
prices.
Like, usually with me, I'm gonna go to the AMC.
Depends on the price of the movie.
Yeah. Like, I'll come from the top family. If that's too expensive, we're not going.
I'm hoping it will work out great because downtown Fort Mill is really growing, and I think it's awesome when they take the historical buildings and renovate them. It keeps like the town's charm, but it still is like new and exciting. So I really hope it does well because it's a great location.
Would you go to the Main Street Theater, and how do you think it will work out?
I don't know who is in charge of construction, but it's definitely a worthwhile project. And if it gets up and running, it'll offer a lot of opportunities for students and their families and other people in the community to see more arts production, which I'm a 100% fan of.
Fun fact, 10 cents used to buy you a ticket, popcorn, and your drink.
We asked people what they thought about that.
Hannah and Skylar bring you a new series of episodes, School Through the Ages.
This week's episode is School in the 70s.
So, what classes do you have next?
None, man, I'm leaving.
Man, but don't get caught by the man.
Catch you on the flip side.
All right, class, I'm going to take attendance. Betty.
It's Betty.
Hazel. Are you here, Hazel?
Hazel's not here.
Hazel will not be joining us. Such a hassle on me.
Look outside.
Peace, love, and hugs. Peace, love, and hugs.
Hazel, get back in here.
Do you need a hug? I'm only coming in if you said you needed a hug.
Worthless.
Aw, oh, man, I didn't bring enough cash for lunch today.
Oh, yeah, and they had rectangle pizza. My fave.
BTMS has some history of its own.
Carrington highlights some of the school players from the past.
Hi guys, my name is Miss Tyler, and I'm the theater arts teacher, if you don't know me yet. And here at Banks Trail, musicals have been a big thing since the beginning, or large plays. So, we started in 2011 with The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. It was a straight play, but it included a whole lot of people, and that's really what got our musical started. When we started in the very beginning, it was me and a few students moving and parents moving sets and painting sets, and really the students are why the theater program has grown so much in the past 7 years. So we couldn't do it without you. Okay, so then a few years later, we did our very first musical. It was Willy Wonka, and so it was a lot of fun. That was the first time that we had full sets, so it was a big deal. All right, then we've done a lot of other ones. We've done Charlotte's Web, we've done Secret Garden, we've done Alice in Wonderland, the play and the musical. And one of my favorites that we've ever done is Annie. And the reason that I really enjoyed Annie is it was the first realistic play that we've done. We often do fantasy, which is fun and it's great, but with acting, when you do a realistic play, the actors can really show every aspect of their talent. So that was super exciting for me because I got to see some actors really grow into professional performers with the more dramatic scenes. So that was really fun. But this year we're doing Little Mermaid and we're super, super excited. The musicals are open to 7th and 8th grade. So if you're in 6th grade, we really, really hope you come and consider joining our class next year. And there's a few opportunities in January to learn how to run the lights and the sound or hand out programs. So if you're interested, stay tuned for that. And our show is March 1st through the 3rd, and we hope to see you there. So come see the
every day. No one ever knew we were there.
You can capture the moment for only $35.
How do you order a yearbook?
It's really simple. You go to the Banks Trail Middle School website, click on Pay Fees, click Yearbook, and put in your credit card information. Once that's all done, you'll be automatically added to the list.
How much are the yearbooks?
If you order before Christmas break, they're $35. After that, they're $40.
That's all we have for you today.
See you next time on The How. I will hurt you.